In our first step, if you're using a new device, turn on your location, especially if you're in the same area where you used to log into your account. This helps ensure that Google detects the same IP address that was used in previous login attempts. Next, you're going to use a browser. Before you open that browser, long press on its icon on the home screen, select App Info, go to Permissions and allow access to your location. Once that's done, open your browser and search for Google Account Recovery. In the search results, select the first option, and that is how to recover your Google account or Gmail. Next, scroll down to the Forgot Your Password section. Now, if you've already tried to recover your account and failed, you click on If You Have Trouble, Try the Tips to Complete Account Recovery Steps. Next, you click on Go to the Account Recovery page, which will take you to the recovery page. From there, enter the email address you're trying to recover. Next, you'll be prompted to enter your password. If you don't remember your last password, use the previous one that you do remember. The more recent it was, the better. But if you can't recall any previous passwords, make your best guess. Once you've entered the password, you click on Next. Now, if you didn't set up other recovery options like in my case, you might be denied access at this point. This is where we now move on to the second step, which is using a special recovery link. Since it's not publicly available in the search results, I'll share a shortcut link. So open a notepad or any document where you can type, and then type this link. So I'll put this link in the description of the video so that you can copy direct. Now, after typing that, you can copy the link and paste it into your browser. From there, enter your email address again. Then enter your password when prompted to do so. Now, the difference this time is that they will ask you for a contact email. So enter an email address where they can reach you for the next steps in the recovery process. After that, a verification code will then be sent to that email address. So make sure to copy it and paste it into the designated field. Once you enter the code and click Next, a new page appears asking you to reply to your Google support email or contact to let the team know you've successfully completed your account recovery request. Now, under Try Signing In Again, in the bottom of that page, you click on Recover Your Account. This will still take you to the recovery page, but in that page, scroll down to the bottom and select Post to the Help Community. Then scroll down again and click Post a Question. In the summary of your issue, type Google Account Recovery. In the description of the problem you're facing, explain that you've tried recovering your account but can't proceed past the step where you're supposed to reply to a Google support email. Now, remember not to include any private or confidential information such as your email address. After that, move on to the next step, which is the category. There, select Account Access and Recovery. Click Next, then select Account Recovery. Click Next Step again. Click Next Step again. So now you can choose the platform you're using, either Android or iOS, though that part is optional, you can skip it. Finally, select Yes, Include for better visibility, then click Next Step. You can edit your display name if needed, and finally click Post. From there, your question will be posted to the Google Community Forum, where a Google expert will respond. Now, when you receive a response from one of the experts, it will contain another recovery link. Follow the steps included in the email, but if you still have trouble, here is what worked for me. Let your account sit idle for a full week without any sign-in or account recovery attempts. Just leave it inactive for 1 week, as this may help clear any flags related to suspicious activity, allowing you to attempt account recovery with more questions being asked.